It's absolutely outstanding what the Vegas Golden Knights have done. Here's the kicker. There's 41 games to go. You cannot rest on your laurels. You got to stay focused. You got to stay in the moment. George McPhee built this team. Gerard Glent, great coach. Maybe on, you know, almost a runaway winner other than John Hines in New Jersey to win Coach of the Year.
Leaves it back to William Karlsson. Goals in two straight and 22 on the season to lead the team. Connor McDavid in transition. Trying to fight through Karlsson. Swings behind and had a wraparound chance. Snuffed out by Fleury.
And Karlsson does a nice job getting back on the defensive side here, but McDavid just protects that puck. Quick little wraparound play as Fleury gets that left skate against the post.
Off this faceoff, David Perron with it. Brad Hunt straight away, not a Miller, feeds it wide of the net. Perron coming off the half wall, down low, Neal spins, puts it in front, and Talbot got a pat on it.
Best chance on the power play for the Golden Knights. Little play down to the goal line as Perron to Neal, and he just walks it out. He loses control, but gets a second chance as he bats it towards that far side. It goes off Talbot's stick, and then off his right pad.
I don't know how many of the Oilers just going to stay put.
Sure, there'll be a few of them.
There's Sekera trying to feed Dreisaitl in a side flurry. Leon Dreisaitl frustrated with himself. Flurry with the left pad.
As Sekera, little pass right down to the goal line, and Dreisaitl a quick shot, but Flurry reads this all the way, able to adjust and move up against the post to make the save.
Banks it indirect up the boards. McDavid trying to fight through a hit. But Hunt closing on him. Pretty much, I would think, Shane, imperative to take away his time and space right away if you can. Puts it on net and a safe flurry.
On a NHL that gets faster and faster every year, he leads the way, and this is an example. His ability to do it with the puck. It's like one crossover, those lateral strides, takes it to the net, able to get a shot out of nothing.
Sitting 2 points away from 200 already in his NHL career. Those numbers actually would be better. He missed about half the season as a rookie with a broken collarbone. Now here's Englund with a wrist shot, tipped and a save, Talbot. He'll hold it. Eakin got a piece of that.
The shot was going wide, but he shot for the stick. Eakin gets a stick on it, and a nice save by Talbot off the redirect as he follows that puck and able to hang on. Good chance there off just a simple shot from the point by Derek Englund.
Now Perron with a wrist shot. That's blocked. Perron looking to stay with it. All wrapped up with Dreisaitl. Perron protects the puck, throws it on net, and Talbot able to steer it away.
Perron just so strong on that puck, walks it off the wall, wins the battle, and a quick shot, trying to look for some room to the short side.
And to work his way loose. So check it out, it was McDavid. Now here's Maroon, plays it across, Nurse into the offensive end, trying to turn McNabb, throws it in front, score! Patrick Maroon at the top of the crease puts in his 11th of the season.
And a nice rush as Darnell Nurse is just going to jump up the ice and throw it to the front of the net. And Patrick Maroon crashes to the front and gets it underneath Marc-Andre Fleury as the Oilers grab the 1-0 lead. A nice job by Nurse protecting the puck, throws it out front. Had a pair of goals last night against Arizona. And this one goes off Maroon's skate and between the pads of Fleury.
Derek Englund with some open ice. Makes his way to the Oiler line. Driving down the boards and a wrist shot turned away by the mask of Talbot. Riley Smith trying to dart his way loose. Dangles in a little further and scores! What a move by Riley Smith! Upstairs on Talbot to tie the game!
And Smith's just going to take it from below the goal line. Recognizes the ice, little point, backhand, forehand, right up top over the left shoulder of Cam Talbot. And Riley Smith ties this game. That is a fantastic move and a great finish to elevate that puck so quickly and tight.
Up ice Howla. Good work though by McDavid again in his way. And McDavid lost it. Eakin to the net, drop pass to Howla, and McDavid picked it off. McDavid will lead the charge the other way. Into the offensive zone. Shot of the set made Fleury and Dreisaitl.
Here's Eakin. Howell is calling for the puck, but he gets it a little late. McDavid picks off the pass. Back they go on an odd man rush. And then McDavid's going to find Dreisaitl off to the side, to the left of Fleury. And Marc-Andre Fleury able to close the pass. Dreisaitl looking for a little bit of light between them in the five hole, and Fleury comes up with a save.
Smith racing after it. Cut off by Russell. They both go hard to the end boys. Marchessault picking up with 8 seconds. In front to Carlson. Score! William Carlson from close range. And the Golden Knights lay 10-1.
As the period's winding down, Smith stays on top of Russell. Good support from Marchessault. And Carlson just pops into that spot. And a great feed. These three guys work so well together, but it's hard work. Riley Smith doesn't quit. Marchessault support underneath, and Carlson just spins open right between the hash.
And now the puck kicks to James Neal. Here's Perron to the blue line. Gains the zone. Theodore right side. Shot set Talbot. Neal throwing it back towards the net. That's kicked away.
The play, Perron protects the puck. Little play as Theodore jumps into the rush. The first shot, Theodore can't get a handle, and James Neal comes in right after. As Theodore trying to go blocker side, just catches the right shoulder of Cam Talbot.
Leads it in the middle, McNabb, but that one outside the blue line. Delayed offside, waved off. McDavid sprinting right up the middle. Now to Maroon to Cajula. Score! Drake Cajula with his first goal in 10 games, and the Oilers have tied it early in the third period.
That's a turnover. It gets started by McDavid. A little kick out to the side and over to Cajula, and a great shot as he goes upstairs. There's Connor McDavid. He just takes off. Great feed by Maroon over Cajula, and a great finish as this game gets tied at 2.
Golden Knights hoping that the 6th power play will be a charm, but Camilleri to move into McDavid. Said the Oilers with 7 shorthanded goals this year. McDavid to the net, and Fleury dragged that back pad to kick it out.
As he just goes wide, that's that little change of speed. That little crossover to the outside drives the net.
Fans here at T-Mobile, a lot of Oiler fans have made the way here from Edmonton. Here's Neal to Holla, passing off his skate, and then Holla puts it wide.
James Neal made a great play in the neutral zone, stripped the puck off Lucic. And it's a 1-on-2. Can't get the puck away, but he protects it afterwards. Able to get it over to Howell, who tried a little spin shot. That just went wide of the net.
Eakin the first one in to play it. He's under 5 minutes to go in the third. Digging it out is Tuck. In front to Carrier to St. Talbot. That got deflected on the way to the net, and Talbot kicked it out with a right pad.
Some good work down low again by Tuck. This time center. The pass is on the tape. Goes off a stick, and then Cam Talbot with a great right pad save.
Oh, great setup, but the pass didn't click in front. Back comes Cajula the other way for Edmonton. Feeds it in the middle. Nurse to the net. Shot! Score! Darnell Nurse with the overtime winner. His 3rd goal in the last 2 nights.
And that somehow finds its way through Marc-Andre Fleury under the left arm. And the Edmonton Oilers will win this one in overtime as they have 2 victories against the Golden Knights this season. Darnell Nurse, 2 goals last night, a goal tonight. He is having himself a career year.
They have 4 goals in the last 4 games in all, but Darnell Nurse. And it came early in overtime as the Oilers win it.